It's at the heart of every gear change across a race weekend, enabling our gearbox to switch up gear at the blink of an eye, all while giving our driver performance advancements and extending the life of our most crucial components. Hello and welcome to episode 4 of this 6-part technical series as we take a closer look at the 5 Petronas functional fluids. And today we're focusing in on the Tutela gearbox oil. So let's jump on into what we have here in front of us. It's a gearbox, but not as I've ever seen one before. So James, do you mind talking us through exactly what's happening here?
Of course. So here we have a Formula One transmission for our input shaft here out to our final drive. So we have 8 gears. Formula One cars have 8 gears, which are housed in here with the selection mechanism. We have our cross shaft area, final drive, differential, and then out to the rear wheels.
Amazing. Thank you. And I'm guessing for that, we need a specific oil, a Tutela oil that's going to assist the gearbox. So how does that differentiate between what I could put in my own car?
So we have here Tutela gearbox oil, which is specifically formulated for the F1 gearbox. Specifically formulated because we have extreme conditions. So we have high load, high speed, high torque, and really high temperatures. So we need to guarantee reliability while ensuring also efficiency.
And James, what kind of challenges is this gearbox going to face when we're out on track?
Yeah, it's facing quite a lot. We are running at very high speed. We are running at very high torque, so there's a lot of load going in this gearbox, and it generates a lot of heat. And the oil has two functions. We are always trying to lubricate the areas where they're of contact, so the gears and the bearings, and the oil has always been flung away from where we want it. And so part of the design of this gearbox is to make sure we put the oil exactly where we want it, and also to ensure that we're always picking up that oil out of the gearbox in order to take it to a cooler, to cool it, and then put it back into the gearbox. And the car on track is, it's always big G-forces going on when we're going around corners, and the oil is moving around in the gearbox. We then have to pick that oil up under all conditions, take it to the cooler and put it back. So there's quite a lot going on.
Yeah, it sounds like it's being pushed through an awful lot of forces. So how do we ensure the reliability as we're allocated 4 gearboxes per driver across the season? So how do we look after these?
So we have formulated the oil using a specific set of additives and also a specific set of viscometrics in order to guarantee enough oil film to guarantee lubrication, ensure lubrication in the gearbox. But then at the same time, we also want performance, so we also want efficiency. So this is this difficult balance trade-off between efficiency and lubrication, where we work quite closely with MGP to find the right oil and the right viscometrics. So you want a low viscosity oil for improving efficiency, but at the same time you want to ensure reliability, so you want to avoid metal-to-metal contact. And this is the work that we do together.
So James, can you talk us through this animation on the gearbox?
Of course. So the gearbox is always found at the back of the car behind the engine. And what we're seeing here is this shaft in the middle transmits the torque from the engine into the gearbox. And as we remove the casing from the gearbox here, we get to the gearbox internals, which are really doing all the work for us. First of all, we get the lay shaft gears, which are these 8 ratios along here, which are highlighted. And then that transmits the rotation, the torque into our main shaft gears, which are highlighted here. And our main shaft gears are then connected to our selection mechanism. So we have dog rings, which are highlighted here, which move backwards and forwards to allow us to change gear. We then get to our bevel gear, which transmits the torque and rotation through 90 degrees, then on to our final drive, and then our differential. And then that goes out to our rear wheels. And that is really how we transmit all of the power from the PU into our rear wheels in the most efficient way possible.
And Salvatore, what kind of challenges is the oil that's within the gearbox facing out on track?
So we want to maintain all levels as low as possible in order to reduce weight. But then when turning on the corners, the oil will move around the gearbox, picking up air. So for mitigating this aeration issue, we add a specific set of additives into the oil and antifoam to mitigate the issue.
Is there any way to perform a health check as well once we're out of track?
Oh, of course, yes. So at the Petronas trackside lab, we can take sample from the gearbox. The gearbox oil is collecting all the debris from the gearbox, and when we put that oil sample into the spectrometer in the lab, it's kind of doing a blood test. So we will spot any particles inside the engine, all the elements, and we can also know the concentration of each of these elements. So we're talking about elements like aluminium, iron, so on. So if we see anywhere that is higher than expected, so higher concentration of these elements, we can communicate with NGP, and then they can decide on the strategy whether to change the gearbox or not in order to avoid any failure of the track.
Excellent. And I know with your designer hat on at the moment, how much have these evolved over the years?
Yeah, I mean, I've done gearboxes for a long time, and every year there's something exciting that we find is new. And that's a very exciting part of our development journey with these units. But what we found recently, particularly with the partnership we have with Petronas, is that we are, with the oil, we're able to extract a lot more performance from our gearboxes than we have done in the past, which has been really, really exciting to be involved with.
Thank you. So Petronas Tutela gearbox oil, it's a crucial element of our challenges. It has to withstand all these extreme conditions, such as high temperatures, all whilst being ready for those rapid gear changes. Join us for our next episode as we take a look at the drag reduction system.